This is Classic FM.
I asked some of the guys at CrossFit if they knew what that monument was. Nobody knows.
I wish you'd shut up about that bloody monument. Should we go and open your presents in a minute? You are, by the way, the hardest person to buy for. I think you're the hardest person in my life to buy for.
Why would there be a monument randomly just put there with no like explanation as to why it's there? I don't get it.
By the way, I did try to get you multiple experience-based gifts, but it just was not on my side this year.
Who would know what it is? Like, who would know? Who could I ask? I googled, like, monument bath, but obviously that didn't help.
I'm gonna start using the tips in my how to talk to your child to talk to you. Because it teaches you how to, like, get your child's attention and how to make your child listen. I think it'll work on husbands too. Come on.
What? Where are we going? Oh, yeah.
Okay. Presents!
Well, don't get too excited. Why? Because they're only like little token presents, because you are literally the hardest man on earth.
You think so?
Yes.
My birthday.
Right, don't. I'm just gonna set the expectations low here because I'm sure you realise that you are the most impossible man to buy for.
I just want a Honda monkey bike.
Well, sorry, it doesn't come in bags this size. So I had a theory behind these presents.
Ooh, fancy wrapping.
So, because I really didn't know what to get you, I thought it would be nice just to put a bit of thought into.
Yeah, that's
and I
cool,
went
man.
Into the bookshop and read loads of blurbs.
John Steinbeck of Mice and Men. Great.
I've never read that, but it's quite a famous
I've
one,
heard
I
of
think.
It, yeah. Amazing.
But I read the blurb and I thought it sounded like something you might like.
Yay. Thanks, Hannah. Oh, more books.
And also, I just thought that while you're... Mum's over, maybe we could go to a coffee shop one morning and have a couple of hours in a coffee shop reading book together.
The White Tiger by Aravind.
Don't even ask.
Winner of the Man Booker Prize. Great.
So this one, I actually bought two copies because I thought we could read it together.
Oh, but then I'll be racing. Then I won't be able to handle you beating me.
I won't be racing, so don't worry.
The versions of us.
It's meant to be like, you know that book you like one day? It's meant to be like that.
Is it?
Yeah, and I you always that say book. That's your favourite book.
So one of my favourite books. I absolutely adore that book.
I thought you might like that.
Ooh, these look fancy. So nice when presents are wrapped up properly, aren't they? I just throw mine in a plastic bag and hand them to you.
I know.
Ooh, hay. Can't go wrong with a bit of hay. Oh, an espresso cup. Yes, Hannah Mags. Yes, Hannah Mags.
The bloody overpriced one at that, I tell
well,
you
it's
that.
Hey, everything's marked
yeah,
up
don't,
massively.
Do not Ooh, smash that.
Look how fancy that is. I'm going to feel so hipsterish.
I thought
like that.
You could...
It's like a little clay
even
cup.
Even if you don't use it, it's quite nice just to put on a shelf in your office or something.
I really like that. Yes.
When I took it to the till, I was like, I can't believe I'm running.
How much did it cost?
I'm not going to tell you.
20 quid.
No, more than that.
Oh, more than 20 quid for a little cup like that? Oh my
but
god.
I think it's like hand.
Oh, it's got a saucer with it.
Yeah.
Oh, sick, man.
Yeah.
This is awesome. I love little stuff like this. Thank you. Little thoughtful presents.
I just thought, I can't go wrong in hay.
No, you can't.
It's like your favourite shop.
That is so nice. Oh, man. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. I hate myself and love myself at the same time.
But the whole theory behind it is that you take, like, a morning or an hour to just sit down with a book and relax.
Yeah, man. I'm
in a
totally
coffee shop
that.
Or at home.
I'm reading my Mice and Men with my fancy...
You've got so many books sitting in your office that you, like, don't touch that I thought, if I get ones that I think you're definitely going to like...
Then, I'm excited. Thank you so much, Hannah. Cheers. Thank you. What was that little head turn all about?
What? I've got lipstick on.
Oh, okay.
Brown lipstick. Do you want brown lipstick on your lips? That head turn. You're paranoid.
Yeah. What's going
on? Well, you are 38 now. I might be looking for a younger one.
Tony, I've got the mental age of an 8-year-old, so don't give me that.
Yeah, that's true.
Right. Thanks, Hannah. I love it.
Good.
It's great. What did you get me, Rufus? Oh, a cow pole, but a box of cow pole. Thanks, mate. Cheers, just what I've always wanted. Thank you. Oh, you want it back? Oh, some present that was. I'm 38 today, which means I'm 2 years off 40, and 40 is basically 60, and 60 is basically dead, so I have 2 years of life left. But it's not all bad, because I picked up some wisdom in my old age. I thought I'd share a few of the things I've learned in my long journey to get to where I am today. So these are 10 things that I've learned. Number one is an obvious one, never wear distressed jeans, we all know that. Number two is another obvious one, always tell the truth, be honest. Number three, with regards to the opposite sex, if you look too hungry then you'll starve. Number four, if the grass always looks greener on the other side, it's probably because there's more manure over there. Bit daddish, that one, isn't it? Number five, never argue with a stupid person, it's just pointless. Number six, you're more likely going to regret the things that you didn't do rather than the things that you did. Number seven, don't make decisions when you're angry and don't make promises when you're happy. Number eight, this one's from our old friend Ernest Hemingway. There is nothing noble in being superior to your fellow man. True nobility comes from being superior to your former self. Nine, have the courage to live the life that you wish to live and not the life others expect of you. Number 10, never, ever associate with anyone who says amazeballs. Those are the 10 things. Hope you enjoyed them. On with the show. Today?
Nope.
Have a guess.
58. Yeah.
Do I look like I'm 58?
Yeah.
Well, you're grounded.
Why?
For 100 years. For 100 years. No. Yes, you are.
Can you?
Yeah.
Oh no.
Oh no. I'm so excited about this. I haven't had an Italian in so long.
I'm wearing my mum's jacket tonight, and the smell of it still, it just reminds me of it so much. I don't wear it very often, and it was like her favourite jacket.
It's got that musty kind of late 80s, yeah. Early 90s,
yeah,
smell,
like
isn't it?
J-Lo perfume.
Yeah. J-Lo perfume. I can't believe some people buy David Beckham perfume. I'd rather spray bleach on myself.
Although, when I was younger, my dad
times. You were a kid, that's acceptable. Yeah. Grilled, fresh, mixed fish. I've still got that plastic hang up about fish, man.
Listening to too much Joe Rogan.
It's not Joe Rogan, it was the guy in Greece, the guy who owned fishing boat. It was like, I don't eat the fish, it's full of plastic. Since he said that, it's really got in my head that whenever I'm eating a fish, I'm just thinking I'm eating a bloody Tesco's plastic bag.
Grayson?
Yeah?
Have you ever seen a statue, monument type thing out of your window on the horizon, if you look out the window?
No. Mum says I'm always supposed to tell the truth, but sometimes I have to break the rules. I have seen the monument, but if I'm telling the truth, he won't shut up about it. And I just want to eat my Weetabix in a little bit of peace.
You excited about school?
Yeah.
What are you going to do today?
Play. Why can't I have a normal dad? A sort of dad that doesn't wear his head backwards, like a 9-year-old, and gets obsessed with silly old monuments. I don't need this nonsense.
Look up. Look up to the stars. Make a wish.
Nothing.
Oh god. You are nothing. Four. You're not a teenager yet, Mr. Grumps.
Nothing.
Would you be done just saying nothing in my face?
Nothing.
Right. Nothing. Bye, Mama.
Nothing.
Such a little scrap.
There's lots of things that can confuse my dad in this life. Things such as people that say maze balls, people that clap for planes land, people that think liking gin is a personality trait. But nothing can confuse my dad more in this life than monument on the horizon.
Jingle bells, ring all the way, that must go, Robin flies away.
At first, he thought a little of it. He buried a small seed of curiosity in the back of his mind. But as the seasons slowly came and then went, the seeds he buried grew into a monstrous vine and totally enveloped him. Unmoving, unwavering, intimidating, and ever beckoning him with its deafening silence. What's its purpose? What's its reason for being on this mortal coil?
Stef and I are just about to go and view another house. This is, I've actually lost count actually how many we've seen now. We've seen quite a few. It turns out it's actually quite tricky finding the house. I think we both had in our heads that the first house that we buy is going to be the house that we end up like growing old in, but we're gradually kind of realizing that's probably not going to be the case. I think we both tend to want quite different things from a property, so it's quite hard to find somewhere that ticks all the boxes.
What do you think of that one?
I like it, but I hate the kitchen in the basement. I really like it, but...
Did you love it?
I love it so much.
Oh, okay.
Did you not? Damn. I think he's looking for more, or he thinks he's looking for more of a renovation type project than I am. I just want to do like cosmetic things like floors and painting and stuff, whereas I think Stef
thinks that he wants to rip all the whole inside out of a house and redo it, but I don't think that would be the case when we actually came down to doing it, because I think renovating is quite a big project and we're both pretty busy as it is, so I just think it would be the worst thing to do. But yeah, we're off to go and see another one, so fingers crossed it'll be like 10th time lucky or something.
We're gonna cut some pumpkins for Halloween, and then we're gonna make a pumpkin ghoulish goulash. But first we need some pumpkins.
We've just picked Grayson up and now we are heading to the pumpkin patch. Are you excited?
Wait until the morning light. Rest, there's nothing to fear, I'm here by your side.
One month, a perfect Instagram, so I make sure that doesn't happen.
Soon enough, if you sleep, little one. Go to sleep.
Grayson had fun smashing up all of the rotten pumpkins, but we picked a couple and now I'm gonna go pay for them and get going.
Hannah's feeding Rufus in a pumpkin patch. That must be one of the most peculiar places you've ever fed him.
Definitely the weirdest.
Definitely. You're the weirdest, Grayson. What we're going to do, Grayson, is we're going to carve the pumpkins and then all the bits that we take out, we're going to make a Halloween-themed pumpkin ghoulish goulash.
Ghoulish goulash. Can you say that?
Ghoulish goulash.
You can. Yeah. When Halloween night comes, I'm going to do that thing that that lady did for trick-or-treating last year. Do you remember that scary house we went to, Gracie?
Yeah.
She had a pumpkin and she'd put loads of jelly in it and she got everybody to put their hand in and she said it was brains. Do you remember?
No.
You don't remember? You probably blocked it out. So we're going to use all the flesh, like this part, for the goulash, yeah?
Yeah. So we're going to keep all those bits to one side.
Look, there's a lovely piece of flesh for the goulash.
Oh, here you go. You've got some flesh for the goulash there.
Flesh.
Grayson, do you know how much weight...
Did you just kiss the pumpkin?
Do you know how much pumpkin wastage there is a year, Grayson?
No.
18,000 tonnes.
It's a lot, isn't it?
Grandma! Grandma, come and judge the pumpkin competition!
On my way!
Which one do you think is the best?
Oh my.
Or the least worst? Either or.
This guy!
What? Okay, second best.
Hannah man! Oh, come on!
I lost, man! I lost! I'm in last place, man! Yes! Right, let's get cooking!
Huge love to the wonderful Knorr for sponsoring us this week. Each year we throw away the equivalent of 360 million portions of pumpkin pie. It's an outrage. To combat the amount of pumpkin waste our silly humans produce each year, they're encouraging the nation to make the most of their pumpkin leftovers this Halloween by making something delicious out of them. Anyway, please check out their website. I've linked below for 5 different spooky pumpkin recipe suggestions. Booyaka.
Winter,
it is, isn't it?
A wintry
nice
dish, isn't it?
Nice warm autumnal dinner.
Oh, that's so good. This is my perfect type of food. It's like it's almost like a bit of like an Irish stew.
Mm-hmm. With a kick.
Mmm. I'm really surprised at how nice this turned out.
You did, you chopped almost, but I love this. All right.
Hey,
okay.
Do you want a cup of tea?
No, thank you.
Why can't I get this bloody monument out of my head?
go up there and see it, I think.
Ow! Burnt myself.
Over the past few weeks, I have been designing and creating a couple of styles of card with Athena from Meticulous Ink in Bath. I've been practicing calligraphy and choosing colour schemes and all of that kind of jazz. They are almost ready to go up live on my Max London website. What I want to do is find small independent brands that I really love, buy some of their stock and sell them on my website. And so far I have two new products coming out. The first one is actually launched today, the Anne facial oil. I raved about this so much on my Instagram stories a while ago. I absolutely love it. It's one of my favorite products that I use on my face, and it's by a good friend of mine as well. It's all natural and I just really love the products. And then coming up, I will also have a set of children's pajamas, which are just amazing. The boys have been wearing this brand for a while, which is also based in Bath. And the whole company is run by one of my friends, and it's just a really lovely brand and a really great product. So the oil is on the site, the cards are coming up, the pajamas are coming up, and I also have a couple of things that I've designed about to go live. Hopefully they will be released in time for Christmas, but yeah, over time I just want to get the site looking a little bit more professional and less like bloggery, I guess. Eventually just start selling things that I've kind of sourced from other independent brands, so yeah.
Okay. And it's, I don't know if you're going to be able to get it from this bottom
fine.
Bit. Those two.
Yeah, that's fine. That looks great. Very nice.
Which, it's not as perfect as I wanted it to be. Then I also thought, I still want it to sort of look like my handwriting.
Exactly. So I will do all the cleanup.
Cool.
And I'll email you a proof.
Al, do you know what that monument is up there, mate? I've asked everyone, nobody knows.
No idea, mate. Maybe you should just ride up there and see what it is.
It's a brilliant idea.
At your item, honeydew, feel the light fills you. Pearly drop on petal's brim, oh, to feel young again. Artemisia in the morning, silver green, all bloom adorning. Held within each sage you whirl, a diamond dewdrop glowing born. Oh, hail, feel the burning deepest, brightest, fervent yearning, candle flame afraid to show, shielding it nobody knows. Still the salvia blooms they blow, tender furry buffaloed by honeybees and bumble friends, do they know the fall draws to an end? Fall, blue sky round came from the garden soil, it bounds my soul, it sings, oh praise the day, my struggling heart might find a way. Spiders and the webs they weave out of sight among the eaves of the house we live in, solid made that holds the lives we choose to lead. Choose to lead, oh choose to lead, I've chosen life, I choose to lead, but what, but how, but why, but where, reaching out I find the air. At your autumn honeydew, feel the light feels you, pearly drop on petals brim, oh to feel young again. Artemisia in the morning, silver green, oak bloom adorning, held within each agey world, diamond dewdrop glowing born. Oh, he'll feel the burning deepest, brightest, fervent yearning, candle flame afraid to show, shielding it nobody knows.
Can you give one to your brother? I'm tired.
Me too. I think this is probably the most beautiful bath gets is in the autumn when all the leaves are turning this colour, because it really complements the stone.
Mm.
That the colour of the bath stone against that, the kind of the colours of the autumn trees.
We should go for a walk on the other side sometime.
Yeah, we should. I think there's so much of it we haven't discovered yet. We need to unearth more of it. I bet there's so many secrets to it that we don't know about. You know what? I did not think it would be this difficult to find a house. I thought we would just like see a couple, be like, oh, that's the right one, and then move in. But
no,
how many have we looked at now?
Can't even remember. Loads.
Such a big decision though, isn't it? Such a big decision. I love how uncommitted he is to walking. He's like,
I know.
I do like two steps and then I'm just going to give up on that.
He likes doing it for attention and then he's like, okay, I'm done now, and he'll just do his little bum scooch thing.
Mm. We're going to have to go back to weekly videos for this foreseeable future, you know, because we've had all that brand work come in.
4 weeks.
Mm. It's a good thing because we've got the work coming, but it's hard for me to keep the standards up when I only have a week to film and produce. It's taken a lot of pressure off us doing it once every other week, hasn't it, of videos? There's more time to... think. I found myself being way less anxious.
I think you probably notice it more than me.
Yeah, true. If you have no... Yeah? Okay, in a minute, I'm just coming now. But, like, in terms of just coming up... Before, we only had one day for it to come up for air, and that was Sundays.
Mm.
And now I feel like I have a few more days to kind of think about stuff and ideas and stuff. I'm coming! All right, I've got to go and get this going.
Oh, here you feel the burning, deepest, brightest, fervent, yearning, candle flame, afraid to show, shielding it, nobody knows. Stylist of your glooms, they blow, tender, furry, buffaloed by honeybees and bumble friends, and they know they've all dressed to an end. Fall, fall, blue sky, round green from the garden, soil abounds my soul, it sings, oh, praise the day, my struggling heart might find a way. Spiders in the webs they weave, out of sight among the eaves of the house we live in, solid made, that holds the lives we choose to lead. Choose to lead, or choose to lead, I've chosen life, I choose to lead, but what, but how, but why, but where, reaching out I find the air.
That was a thing. Breathes just like we do. Only one day the universe stops breathing in and starts to breathe out. It contracts until eventually it becomes a singularity. Every kingdom, dynasty, memory, star, planet, and galaxy, and more. Crushed into the sides of a marble. But then with a big bang, it starts all over again from the very beginning. The universe begins to breathe out again, expanding once more. Time, space, light, matter, and maybe even in the circumstances of just right life. A life like ours, that will maybe, just like us, hold so deeply in love, maybe it's inconceivable for us to believe it, that they'll call it simply.
This is Classic FM.
I asked the guys at CrossFit if it's weird.
Should we go and open your presents in a minute?